my local AMC did not make this a good experience. At least the beginning, and this has nothing to do with the movie itself. It's 100% about my local AMC. So this movie was is in Dolby Cinema. And so I'm sitting there waiting for it to start. Eventually, everything starts, and, you know, about 8 billion ads for AMC, even though, you know, I'm sitting in an AMC. I know where I am, but eventually the trailers begin, and the first trailer is for A Haunting in Venice. Clue number one, that this probably was not going to be A Haunting in Venice. So the previews keep going, and I'm sitting there thinking, these are the exact same trailers, in the exact same order, as when I saw The Nun 2. And lo and behold, guess what started? The Nun 2. So I leave the theater. I politely say, hey, The Nun 2 is playing. It's supposed to be A Haunting in Venice. You know, get your shit together. I didn't say that, but you get the point. So they send someone to the theater to figure the shit out. And the whole thing restarts. Not the trailers. But then out of nowhere, Barbie begins playing. It's like, oh my God. How hard is it to click on A Haunting in Venice, because I know it's all fucking digital. Eventually, the movie did begin, thankfully. So, A Haunting in Venice. It's the third movie in the Detective Poirot saga, the third movie based on a Agatha Christie novel, and this particular one, Halloween Party. So, it's not the same name as Murder on the Orient Express or Death on the Nile. They changed it up a teeny tiny bit. But here, our detective is retired in Venice, and everybody knows that he's there because everyone's following him. Like, oh my God, please solve my mystery. This is happening, and my family is cursed, and oh my God, some stuff is happening. Please solve my mystery. And he just ignores them, which, if I was retired, I'd do the same thing. But then out of nowhere comes Tina Fey's character, which is like, okay, Tina Fey in a horror movie. Let's fucking go. She is an American writer and has apparently written all of Poirot's, like, big cases into books, into novels, and she's made fucking shitload of money, and he's just been like, yeah, whatever. But there's a psychic that she cannot figure out. If she might be real, she might be fake, but if she's fake, she can't see it. So she needs the second smartest person, because of course she is, to figure it out. And of course, murder happens. And there was a murder before. It wasn't suicide, as like everyone was led to believe. So it's like, okay, this could be interesting. And it is interesting. Branagh is absolutely amazing as Poirot. He also returns as the director. So, you know, he's putting on two hats here again, and he's killing it. Tina Fey, too, is fantastic. Especially her and Branagh as a, like, on-screen pair. They're fucking amazing. And there's twists and turns everywhere. Did this person do it? Did that person do it? Oh my God, it was this person. No fucking way. And every single character has their own tragic backstory. It's just a little ridiculous, but it's still very interesting. My only real issue with the movie is that it is so incredibly slow moving. There were moments where I was in the theater literally like this in my seat, because, like, I'm sitting there and, like, I want this to continue. Move forward, please. But it takes what seems like forever to get to the point. And that's the main issue I have with this movie. The performances are great. Branagh, Tina Fey, Michelle Yao, who plays the psychic, small part, but she fucking kills it in the time that she's given. And, like, I wanted to see more, but I also wanted it to be over, because that's just how slow-moving it was. Ultimately, A Haunting in Venice, I think it is a good movie. Like I said, the performances are great. There's twists and turns absolutely everywhere. And the ending is like, whoa, okay, that's very interesting. But the problem is, it takes forever to get to it. I mean, it's only like an hour 40 long, so it's not super, super long. But it feels long because of just how slow moving and how slowly the plot just creeps across the screen. So, I give A Haunting in Venice a B minus.
Did you enjoy the review? Make sure to hit that like button and subscribe to get notified when more reviews go live. Feel free to leave a comment to discuss your thoughts on the movie or show, and I will see you next time.